Josh. Time to go.
Five more minutes.
No. I'm counting to three and then I'm gonna get mad.
Five more minutes.
One, two, two and a half. Come on. What do you want for dinner?
Chinese.
You had Chinese last night.
I have to do it every day.
Why?
Be a kung fu master.
Well, show me your moves, Jackie Chan. You ready for your tournament tonight?
Yeah, I'm gonna make him bleed. I'm gonna make him cry. I'm gonna make him run home to his mama.
Who?
Michael. I hate him.
But he's like your friend.
Not anymore.
Why not?
Because he picks on people.
Does he pick on you?
Sometimes.
Well, I'm gonna start his mother back.
Write this down. 7:12 p.m.
You okay?
Yeah.
So what'd you see?
You don't want to know.
Yes, I do. Think I do this for the great benefits package?
All right, cool. Jenna, don't forget your shrink appointment today. I don't want to hear you skipped another one.
Oh, thanks, Jenna. Thanks for helping.
Thanks for keeping my brain stable while I jump through time.
No problem, Sam. Glad I could help.
Check it out. Oh, yeah. Detroit City got me gritty. I'm filthy. I can't help it. I really hope to make it with this hand I was dealt with. Staring out the rear view, looking for a clear view. It's hard to pray to God when you feel the devil's near you. Kids turn to burglars, streets are full of murders. Enough to turn you cold, so we all pack burners. Junkies by the burners, and they trying to keep warm. Doing right ain't feeling right, so I'd rather do wrong. The world's on fire, you can hear the bodies burning. The oil's running out, but the wheels keep turning.
Things that she can cook, meatloaf. So I get home. Good if you burn your mouth.
Let's go.
That's the guy. That's the psychic. Ooh.
Laugh all you want. The psychic's put 22 perps behind bars.
He took the car, but it's not what he was after.
The purse?
It was her. He was there to kill her. It was a hit. Murder for hire.
Who hired him, Sam?
Spina's cell phone records. He made a phone call at 12 after 7.
Come on, how does he know this stuff?
Never mind. Get the ex-husband's phone records. See if he received a call at 7:12 that night.
I suspected the ex. The way that kid's left unharmed.
Excuse me, Detective...
Nicholas.
The kid wasn't unharmed. He saw his mother bludgeoned to death. I assume my check is downstairs.
I don't know how you know what you know, but I know that you ain't no psychic. Prove me wrong. Tell me the first thing my wife ever said to me. Real psychics know that kind of shit, Sam.
I look forward to your next call, Detective. This ought to settle us up for this month and next.
Look at you. Ain't you the sweetest thing? The way you take care of your sister. About as sweet as pumpkin pie.
Yes, you are.
About as sweet as pumpkin pie with some whipped cream on that sweet little ass of yours.
Yeah, you know, I actually gotta get going because I've got ice cream and groceries.
I need to introduce you to my niece, Roxanne.
I'd love to meet her.
Okay, I'll get a number for you.
Yeah,
all right,
okay.
Now you stay right there. I'll be right back.
Right. Jenna. Didn't hear me knocking?
No, it was you.
Who'd you think it was?
Gestapo.
You ever open up a window in here?
What, and lose the ambiance? You're never gonna believe what happened last night.
Try me.
The Kalowitzes next door were up late fighting.
Shocking.
Let me get to the good part. She drops the D-bomb. Divorce. So it looks like apartment 3B might be opening up. You could grab it. We could be neighbors.
Yeah, then you could stay up late eavesdropping on me.
Oh, yeah. Eavesdropping on your exciting social life.
This thing's gonna fucking kill you.
Godspeed. So how was work, Mr. Police Psychic? We ever find out who killed Mommy in the park? Get an ID?
Yeah, it was some gun the ex hired.
It's always the ex. I should warn Peggy before she serves Kevin those divorce papers.
To do that, you'd actually have to leave your apartment. Sorry, that was just a joke.
Anyway, I leave my apartment. In fact, I went out just this morning to see my psychoanalyst.
Great. No, seriously, Jenna, that's great. What did she have to say?
She agreed with me that it's really unhealthy that we never talk about what happened in the fire. She said that the more I know about what happened, the more I'll be free of it. Seriously, can we talk about it?
What is there to talk about? Jenna, were you gonna pay this, or?
The police said that it was a gas leak, but you came in from outside.
I smelled smoke. I didn't know where it was coming from. I thought it was the neighbor's house, so I went outside to look.
And you got a ladder?
Yeah.
It just doesn't make any sense. How did you have time to go to the shed and get a ladder?
No, I don't remember, Jenna. I don't remember. I don't want to remember. I was 15 years old. Is that enough, Jenna? Is the interrogation over? Ice cream's in the freezer.
Sam. Thanks for the groceries. What are you doing tomorrow? You want to come over for dinner? I could make a casserole.
Yeah, I'll come by tomorrow.
Promise?
What are we, in the third grade?
Promise?
Pinky swear. All right. Get some sleep tonight, okay? Can I help you?
You don't recognize me. Elizabeth Brown? Rebecca's sister? Nice to see you too.
I'm sorry. Come on in.
Nice place.
Thank you. Yes, it's all right.
Hey, let me clean off the seat.
Oh, no, don't. Sam, don't worry about it.
By the way. So, what brings you to my part of town?
I came back for the execution. They're executing Lonnie on Friday. Lethal injection.
Lonnie
Flennens. The guy they say killed Rebecca.
Sam, you act like you don't know what I'm talking about.
No, I yeah, of course. I just hadn't thought about Rebecca in a long time, that's all. You, want a drink? So, what are you doing here?
Lonnie didn't kill my sister.
And how do you know that?
Well, because I found this diary when I was helping my parents move. Rebecca wrote about you a lot, Sam. About how much she loved you. Do you remember when Lonnie tried to convince the jury during the trial that, you know, they were having a relationship? Do you remember?
Yeah, I remember.
It was true, Sam. Rebecca was cheating on you. I know this hurts. Look, May 18th, 1998. Someone has been following me. It's definitely not Sam. He doesn't know about Lonnie, but I have to tell him. I feel so guilty. I don't know what to do. I took this diary to the cops. They say it's not sufficient evidence to reopen the case.
Well, that's what they said.
And then I talked to your friend, Detective Glenn. Sam. He told me that you have a way of knowing things that nobody else knows. That you can see into crime. Sam, I want to hire you. I have $5,000 in cash, okay? Here.
I can't, Elizabeth.
Why?
It's complicated, I'm sorry.
Complicated, but the guy that killed Rebecca got away. And Lonnie Flennens, an innocent man, a man she loved, is going to die.
I wish I could help. I do. I'm sorry.
Sam. Okay.
Elizabeth, you forgot this.
Keep it. She would have wanted you to have it.
So, tell me about this dead girl. Did you love her?
Rebecca Brown. First girl I ever fell for.
You never thought about jumping back before?
Thought about it 100 times. It just...
But you know better. Sam, this is serious shit. There's 2 big rules. You never jump back to alter your own past, and you never jump unsupervised.
What if I just go back and nobody sees me if I do exactly as you taught me and just observe?
Come on. Let's be honest with ourselves. Do you really think that you can go back and watch your girlfriend get murdered and not intervene?
I've seen dozens of people killed right before my eyes and I haven't lifted a finger.
Well, this is different, Sam. You've seen for yourself what happens if you break these rules. Your sister dies in a fire. You jump back thinking you can save her. And you do. But what you didn't expect was that your parents were gonna die instead. You try to save one life, you kill 2. How many times you gotta jump back before you know the rules? 15, 20?
Enough to know I don't wanna do it anymore.
Exactly. No, you nearly fried your brain. You can't handle that many overlaps. It'll drive you crazy. Get another round here, sweetheart.
Save it, Goldberg. You gave me an F in freshman physics, remember?
Oh, and you're never going to let me live it down.
You start tipping, I might.
Keep the change. Everybody's happy.
I know it's hard, man. You know, for whatever reason, your girl Rebecca had to die.
And I've had to live with it.
Not saving someone's life isn't the same thing as killing them, Sam.
No. But it's close.
You do a good thing, Sam. You bring a lot of closure to people.
Everybody but myself.
You gotta stop living in the past. You gotta get this girl out of your mind. She's dead. You're never gonna see her again. And if you wanna help this poor death row bastard, then you better find a way to do it in the here and now. It's like my ex-wife used to say before she ran out to Ecuador with the fucking gardener. You gotta live in the moment, man. Carpe diem.
This one's on the house.
Thanks. What is it?
A buttery nipple.
I'm sorry, I can't. I just can't.
Come on.
Please. Vicky, I need to be alone right now.
Do you want to talk about it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Nothing personal.
What? Are you gay? I could introduce you to my friend Brendan. He's gay too. Maybe you guys can hang out. Well, I'll be sure to give you his number and you can go, you know, do man things. Sound good?
Hey, Liz, it's Sam. I changed my mind. I'll help you out. You got 5 minutes. Sam Reed, remember me? South Pontiac High. South Pontiac Grizzly Bears. I'm here to help you.
Lonnie, I know you didn't kill Rebecca Brown. Jesus, Lonnie, say something.
Why are you here?
I just told you.
You here to laugh at me?
No, look, Lonnie, I know you loved Rebecca. I know she loved you. I know what was going on. She wrote all about it, right here.
What are you trying to do?
We can get a new trial. Lonnie, I don't think you heard me. This is new evidence. The police don't want to reopen the case, but we can request a stay of execution. New evidence, new trial. You'll be exonerated. Do you understand? I'm sending this to your lawyer.
No.
Lonnie, would you just look at the diary?
It was you. You killed her. And I've been locked in here for 10 years! You've been free! You can't come in here and do this to me! You can't pretend to be the good guy now! It's not fair! It's not fair! You did it, Sam!
As a princess?
You should be in here!
Let's go.
You did it, Sam! It's not fair!
This cold.
So what's on the menu tonight? Homicide, rape, vehicular manslaughter.
Rebecca Brown. Sam, what are you doing?
It's okay, Jenna. Just give me the numbers.
You're breaking the rules.
They're my rules to break.
You can't save her, Sam.
I can do this here, the safe way, but I can do it at home by myself and risk everything.
Sam,
either way, I'm gonna do it.
This is a bad idea.
The numbers.
June 6, 1998. Murder happened approximately 12:40 a.m. on Saturday.
Weekend. Come on, I got some wine coolers. Becky calls it bitch beer. You want some bitch beer?
Get back in the car.
I'm not getting back in my car.
Liz, you're in danger. This is serious, okay? Get in the car. Okay? Come on. Keep the doors locked. If you see anything, honk your horn.
Rebecca? Rebecca.
Hey man, you okay?
Who are you?
Paco. You know? I rent your couch.
I rent out my couch?
It's a recession, pendejo.
Where are my car keys?
Car keys? You don't have a car.
Stop showing up here.
We need the case filed on Rebecca Brown murder.
This is the last time.
So who is this guy?
He was a suspect in the Brown murder 10 years ago, but now he's obsessed with the case.
Well, you think he might be our guy?
I think he's just a lost soul.
Hey, let's show him the others.
What?
If he's the killer, we'll know. Paper's calling our guy the Pontiac Killer. You like that name?
What's his pattern?
Tracks young women and cuts them apart.
8 victims so far that we know of. It's about 1 a year.
Any leads?
You got a lot of questions, buddy.
Yeah, well, you don't seem to have any answers.
Hello?
Jenna, hey.
Sam, where have you been? Are you okay?
I've been trying to reach you.
No, I'm fine, I'm fine. I need some help.
What's wrong, you need money?
No. Listen, Jenna, do you remember Lonnie Flennan's?
Of course I do, every time I see his stupid commercials.
Flennan's and Monahan, attorneys at law.
He's a lawyer?
Sam, you need to leave Lonnie alone.
What are you talking about?
Did you jump again? You did,
didn't you? I thought we talked about this. Sam, I'm worried about you.
Jenna. Don't worry about it, okay? I'll be by later and I'll explain everything.
Okay.
Which office is Lonnie Flennan's?
Do you have an appointment?
This one?
Sir, you can't go in there! Sir! Sir, you can't go in there! You can't go in there, sir!
I need to talk to you.
I'm sorry. I told him he couldn't come in.
It's okay. We're old friends.
Where were you the night of the murders?
What is this? Is this our anniversary?
You come in here and you ask me the same question every 5 years?
I want to know where you were.
You still think I was involved? Oh, come on.
Like everybody knows, Becky and Elizabeth were victims of the Pontiac Killer.
I mean, Jesus, where you been, living under a rock?
Tell me where you were!
night they were killed, I thought of stopping by the house. Becca called me and told me her parents were out of town. I saw you and Elizabeth talking outside. I thought I should steer clear. She hadn't told you about us, and I went home, and that was that. I was cleared of all charges.
Yeah. Let's just say your name's been added back to the suspect pool.
I'm all for anti-discrimination. Hell, I made my living at it. Come on, Sam.
Fine, what happened?
And stop it.
When did this happen?
Well, you don't remember?
I forget things sometimes. I get confused. I get mixed up.
Hey, Lonnie, let's get together. Let's have a drink. And then one drink turns into 20 drinks, and then you get a cab that night.
How long ago was this?
June 6, 2003. It was 5 years after the...
Sorry. I'm sorry.
You know, for the longest time, I was convinced you killed the Brown sisters.
Me?
Yeah. Rebecca was always afraid you'd find out about us. So I just thought you were watching her. You know, waiting around the corner, spying. Did you kill him, Sam?
No. I didn't.
I spent years teaching you to use your gift, and now you've created the Pontiac Killer.
Shit.
Man.
I can fix it, though.
Good.
If I just jump back to the night Rebecca and Elizabeth were killed, except an hour earlier this time.
Well, that's not gonna work. I'll tell you, you go back to a time that you've already jumped, you're gonna end up frying your brain. Hey, don't sniff that. Unless you really want to lie on the floor here paralyzed for the next hour. That right there? That's Burundunga. It's the devil's breath.
And you grow this because?
It's fucking Detroit, man. Put a few of those under my window? Cheaper than buying a burglar alarm.
Okay, so what if I go back 4 hours before the murders?
Won't work.
Goldberg. I've created a serial killer. I have to stop it.
Okay, here's what you can do. You said there's 8 murders, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so go back to the next one, victim number 3.
Well, wait, what about Elizabeth?
Stop. You got to stick to the rules. Stick to the rules. Just observe. Observe, like you always do. And this victim number 3, is this, it's nobody you know, right?
Right.
Good. Then you ID the killer. Yeah. I mean, beyond the shadow of a frickin' doubt. Then you go to the police, drop up a dope, turn them in. And then there's just one more thing. You'll be altering the course of events significantly. So when you get back, that is, if it worked, when you come back.
No, thank you.
Shit, I lost my train of thought. What were we talking about?
It's okay, Goldberg, I think I got it. I come back, serial killer's behind bars.
Serial killer, that's right, yeah, that's it. Behind the bars, yeah, that's good.
Thanks, Goldberg. You're brilliant.
Brilliant, yeah, okay. Thought you were gonna say sexy. Hey, that's okay. No problem. Still gonna have a good day. Hey, wait! Don't forget. Jenna put in an order. I can't get over there today.
Nice of you to show up.
You cleaned up?
No, I didn't. What's this?
Victim number 3, Anita Barnes.
Sam, no.
It's okay.
I don't know her. This is business as usual. I pop back and ID the perp.
You gotta be kidding me. I'm not letting you do this. Every time you go back, people die. Can't you learn that?
Police don't have any leads. I'm the only one who can stop him.
Think this through, Sam. I mean, how bad does it have to get?
I can fix this.
I'm not helping you this time. Sam.
Oh. Goldberg says hi. Okay, victim number 3. Anita Barnes. Sorry.
What? I didn't even say the safe word.
I can't do this.
You are doing great.
I know it's just, you know, I can't get hard when you're screaming and crying like that. It's upsetting. I just...
You know I'm enjoying this.
I know, it's just...
I mean, Cosmo said if we treat this like a game, we can have fun with this.
I know what Cosmo says, okay?
I mean, we need to do something, otherwise...
I know. How are we gonna... I know. You remind me all the time, okay? But this shit is weird. It feels wrong.
Why?
Because I'm enjoying it.
But I
I'm enjoying it too.
I shouldn't enjoy raping you. That's crazy.
You're completely overanalyzing this.
Okay, I know. Every time I start thinking, it's just I can't get hard. It's like fucking up my vibe. And now, right, my mind's racing a million miles.
You know what? Don't worry. It's okay. Just go get the accommodator.
The fuck?
I can explain.
What are you doing in the closet, you pervert?
I'm the pervert.
I want you out of here, pendejo, or I call the cops.
The fuck you talking about, man?
You rent my couch, you pay me. You don't pay me, you find somewhere to sleep, pendejo.
Right, fine, man. I'll be out of here. Don't worry.
I'll be out of here next week, or week before last. 2 days ago. Fuck you.
Sorry, don't be scared, okay? I'm
get away
just,
from me.
I need to ask you a few questions, okay?
I have a restraining order against you.
What?
You're that girl from the closet.
No, wait, no, listen, I can explain that, okay? I was trying to protect you, and I think it worked, but I need to figure out why you're still alive.
Somebody please help! Call the cops!
Shh, listen.
Please
you
help
know,
me!
You ever met somebody named Lonnie Fleming?
Please help!
No, no, no! It's okay, I know her.
No, you're not. Look at you.
Just pepper spray. I'm fine.
What happened?
Nothing.
Let me see.
I'm fine! Does the name Anita Barnes mean anything to you?
You jumped without me. Sam, do you know how dangerous that is? You could drown. Your brain could boil. I can't
I don't need
just...
a lecture from you right now, Jenna.
What I need to know, what I need to figure out is why Anita Barnes is still alive. I jumped. I did. I went back and I was supposed to witness her murder. She was victim number 3 of the Pontiac killer. And now I come back and it's just...
What?
Now, I don't know. It's like all the pieces of the puzzle just shifted around. And the only person who could explain it to me is Goldberg. And now he's disappeared.
Yeah, conveniently.
What does that mean?
Sam, He was going to turn in evidence linking you to the murders. If you hadn't fast-forwarded through your past, you'd know that.
What are you talking about?
Sam, you trust me, don't you? I mean, if you're doing this for any reason, I'd never turn you in.
This is ridiculous.
Sam, the night of the Brown murders, I covered for you. I know you weren't at home.
You know where I was. I tried to save them.
Sam, you don't know what happened 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, I know. I didn't kill anybody.
Okay. Maybe not now, but what if with the jumping you go crazy and sometime in the future... Sam, you don't talk about it. You don't talk about anything. You bottle it all up. We've never even talked about what happened in the fire. Did you start the fire?
I saved your life, Jenna. I saw you die. What are your funeral, for fuck's sake? I don't want to hurt people, Jenna. I don't do that. I help people. You see? I help you. I fix things. That's what I do. That's what I did. I went back and I fixed it. I fixed it, Jenna. That's why you're here. Because I fix things. You know, but sometimes you can't fix everything. Sometimes things are just fucked, Jenna. And right now, things are kind of fucked. So I'm trying to fix it, but it I just don't know why.
Sam.
I'm too stupid or I'm too weak. It's just...
Sam. It's gonna be okay. It's the jumping. Just let the police do their job for once. Sam. Promise me you're not gonna jump anymore.
I can fix it, Jenna.
No.
Different. You can go back and change one thing.
Yeah, everyone thinks about that. Hey, want to hear a joke?
Sure.
What do you get when you mix a brown chicken and a brown cow?
I don't know. What do you get?
Brown chicken, brown cow! Funny, right?
Hey, Vicky, you want to come over later?
Thanks for the offer, but I'm gonna be home by the end.
Right.
Yeah.
Maybe in another life.
Yeah, in another life.
Thank you.
Bye, Sam.
Bye. Brown chicken, brown cow.
war to survive. I'm war on my own, hope to make it home alive.
Guess the engagement's off.
Is that all you found?
Forensics recovered charred body matching a description at the Eastern Body Plant.
It's her.
Yep. I'm not sure where's our last customer.
Good sauce.
Says you got in about 3. The murders took place at 2:30 a.m. How long is the walk from the bar to your place? About half an hour?
You really think I'm the Pontiac killer?
You were a person of interest in the Brown murders, but you got off on your sister's alibi. You showed up at Lonnie Flynn's the day before he dies, and now you just happen to be at the bar the night Vicky gets her last manicure.
Come on, Glenn, don't talk about it like that. Don't be a pig.
Guess they need their privacy.
Now I'm gonna tell you how it's gonna happen. You're gonna confess. You're gonna plead insanity. I'm gonna testify myself for what a crazy motherfucker you are. Because if you keep giving me this tired-ass song and dance about trying to stop the Pontiac killer, I'll make sure you're locked up in county with them big old boys. Now, don't it just make an asshole pucker?
Glenn! The sister's here. She's got a lawyer.
So?
She's got Boswitch. You got enough for a conviction?
It's all circumstantial.
Now what?
Go back to the Autobot. Sweep for fingerprints. See what else you can find.
We were already there.
Then look harder.
What are we gonna do about Psychic Boy?
What do you think?
I have to let him walk.
Put a tail on him.
Tigers are looking good this year.
All right, you're letting him out.
Detective Glenn, we got a problem.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, too.
You okay?
Yeah.
How was your night?
What do you want?
I gotta take a shit, pendejo.
5 minutes.
Tired of your fucking 5 minutes.
And I know what pendejo means.
Get the fuck out. You don't pay rent, you leave. I don't give a shit.
till noon today.
Jenna?
Leaving the classifieds on the coffee table. Maybe you can look and see if there's a job in there for you.
Wait, where are you going?
Work. It's Monday.
Oh, that's right.
Oh, I'll be back at 6. You're gonna cook dinner, right?
I make dinner?
Hell yeah. And you said you were gonna clean up. This little project of yours is starting to look kind of scary.
Had this all mapped out.
Look at that.
You may be a nut job, but you sure made this a slam dunk case for us. I mean, your girlfriend Becky cheats on you, so you kill her. Then you kill her sister because, I don't know, like bonus points?
Your pal Goldberg was going to testify against you, then he disappears.
And then you kill Lonnie Flennan's, I don't know.
No.
What?
Well, Lonnie was gonna be executed. I went back. I had to go back.
What the fuck are you talking about? The next victim.
Which one? Yeah. Anita Barnes.
Who?
Anita Barnes. Anita Barnes. Did he kill Anita Barnes?
I don't know. You tell
did
me.
Did I kill Anita Barnes?
No, you tell me.
When was the last Pontiac victim?
Hey, look, fuckstick, I'm asking the questions here. How many did you kill?
I want my phone call. I want my phone call.
You get one call and you call me? You trying to get me fired?
Glenn, I gotta get out of here. Glenn, I'm serious, okay? The killer is still out there, and I'm the only one who can stop him.
According to the Detroit Police Department, the Pontiac killer's right here.
No, come on, you don't believe it's me, Glenn!
I'm in enough trouble as it is, Sam!
Okay. Listen. I'm not a psychic.
I knew it.
I time travel. I can go back to wherever I was, and I can watch. And depending upon what happens, I change things. Usually on accident, but sometimes on purpose.
Don't ever call me again.
No, it's true! Glenn! You made your wife a Tiny Gastro's Sweet 16 party! Her dad got her taco cart in a band from the neighborhood! Your wife came up and asked you to dance! But the first thing she ever said to you was...
Are you MC Hammer?
How did you know that?
I went back. I saw it.
When?
Years ago, when you first started asking me about it. I was saving it. For something like this, actually. So what do you say, huh? You help me out? Please? The hammer?
He's going down as a clerical error, glitching the paperwork. But it'll only buy you a couple more hours. Once Nichols finds out, he'll bring you in. There's no way he'll let me see you again. Come to think of it, I probably won't have a job in a few hours. You catch that son of a bitch.
Favorite customer.
Hey, don't sniff that. Unless you really want to lie on the floor here paralyzed for the next hour.
I'm gonna get your help, Cole.
out of here. Let me get you out of there. Get up. Stand up. I need to get you out of this thing. Good. You know me.
What are you doing here?
It's okay, Sam. Sam, I'll fix everything. I'll just jump back and I'll move the trap out of the way. It'll be fine.
You can jump?
Yeah. Surprise.
Why are you... What are you doing here?
You don't realize this, but I've explained this to you like a zillion times. It's really frustrating. You fell in love with that whore, Sam.
She didn't love you. She was cheating on you.
What whore?
Rebecca Brown. Jesus, Sam, keep up. I took care of it. And everything worked out fine. I even got back at Lonnie Flannan's for hurting you. But then Rebecca Brown's stupid sister comes over and you decide to break the rules, Sam. I told you not to do it. I told you it would be bad.
You followed me back? Jenna, what about the other girls? What about the... You didn't know them. They were strangers. What did they ever do to you?
Can't you see, Sam? They were only strangers because I stopped them before you met them. Anita Barnes. She was the whore you moved to Chicago with. I couldn't let you leave me, Sam. And then Vicky. You kept her a secret from me too, but I found out. She wasn't a lady, Sam. None of them were ladies.
Jenna, they're the women I would have fallen in love with. I would have had a family, a life.
Don't you see I did it all for you? You understand that, don't you?
Why did you torture them? You mutilated them. You cut them to pieces.
I didn't torture them. They tortured me. Every single one of them.
What about Goldberg?
He's catching on. I had to shut him up. This is so Scooby-Doo, isn't it? I would have gotten away with it if it wasn't for those meddling kids.
Get out of your fucking mind, Jenna.
Come on, Sam. No, that's not true. If you hadn't kept jumping back to catch me, I could have stopped. But every time you went back, there was more witnesses. There was more evidence to cover up. It's funny when you think about it. You really did create a serial killer. Ever since the day you jumped back and you saved me, I knew I'd only live for you.
No, Jenna.
Sam. You love me like I love you. It's okay, forget about everything else. This is the moment we've waited for our whole lives.
Jenna, what are you doing?
Sam, we're not like other people. Their rules don't apply to us.
No, Jenna!
Sam,
oh my God.
I love you more than anything in the whole world, Sam. It's okay. It's just you and me, like it's meant to be.
No.
It's okay.
No.
It's okay. Sam, what's wrong? What's wrong? What's going on? Sam, are you okay? Sam, are you jumping? Sam, what's going on? Tell me what's happening. Sam, don't jump. Where are you going? Sam! Sam, don't you leave me. Sam!
care of Mom and I'll get her. Where's Jenna?
Good morning, dork face. Did you sleep well? You must have had some kind of dream. So you were snoring away.
Are we there yet?
Yes, Jenna, we're there.
Jenna?
What, Daddy?
Come on.
Late for your own birthday party. Hello, sweetheart.
Good.
Happy birthday, brother. What?
What do you want, burgers, hot dogs, what?
Whatever you cook and throw it
start
on.
Start with the beer?
Happy
yeah,
birthday.
Sure, hey.
Hey, Jenna.
How are you?
I'm good, I'm good.
Hi, how are you, huh? My son.
How are you?
Oh, good to see
you.
Hey, ma'am.
What can I get you?
But you got a story or two for us, don't you?
Oh, man.
Here you go.
Hey, happy birthday.
Check it out, oh, yeah. Detroit City got me gritty, I'm filthy, I can't help it. I really hope to make it with this hand I was dealt with. Staring at my rearview, looking for a clear view. It's hard to pray to God when you fear the devil's near you. Kids turn to burglars, streets are full of murders. Enough to turn you cold, so we all pack burners. Junkies by the furnace and they trying to keep warm. Doing right and feeling right, so I'd rather do wrong. The world is on fire, you can hear the bodies burning. The oil's running out, but the wheels keep turning. Yeah. Tomorrow ain't certain, so I'm living for today. I hope to go to college, but prison's in the way. Enough stress to turn me gray, so I'm looking much older. Get killed for a coda if you turn the wrong corner. Life expects to see you shorter than you really can imagine. Hope to see 23, the only thing I'm asking. It's another day alone, it's a war to survive. I'm all on my own, hope to make it home alive. It's a street life, street life. It's a street life, street life. My heart turned to stone, man, it's almost like I died. You can run and run forever, but there ain't nowhere to hide. It's the street life, street life. It's the street life, street life. Now, who the hell's there? Somewhere someone's knocking on my door. I feel death is out to get me. Hope to make it out for sure. There ain't a star in the sky, so it's hard to make a wish. Might be the next to die, hard to see through the mist. Blow a kiss from my mother, give a hug to my brother. Light the candle on the mantle, say your prayer, say another. It's the street life, we fight for everything we got. Cause the street life's three strikes, the only thing we got. I make my money in the hallway, fees by the doorway. Sell a pack, make a stack, I'll be here all day. Hustle when it's broad day, forget what the law say. Welcome to the jungle, you a long way from Broadway. Never knock the hustle and ain't really what it sees. Pistol packing in my jeans, seeing demons in my dreams. Now what does it mean when your body turns numb and you're scared of what's coming, so you begin to run. It's another day alone, it's a war to survive. I'm all on my own, hope to make it home alive. It's the street life, street life. It's the street life, street life. My heart turned to stone, man, it's almost like I died. You could run and run forever, but there ain't nowhere to hide. It's the street life, street life. It's the street life, street life. Call the cops, call the SWAT, they got a madman loose. Deuce, deuce, and my goose, ain't no calling the truth. I speak the truth and nothing but it. I'm rugged, I'm quick to bucket. I'm used to having nothing, so I'm always out for something. Never mind all the front and why the hell would I lie? I know exactly where I'm going, why the hell should I try? Everybody's getting locked up, bodies turn up chopped up. Girls are being knocked up, blood is being mopped up. You can get socked up, so watch how you talking. The whole city's scorching, so watch where you're walking. This can happen often, so it's really nothing new to me. Usually, you can catch a kiss before puberty. People screaming unity, but nothing seems to change. Everybody's on the range, I don't know what's in my brain. Enough to make a man insane, all I feel is the rain. I wanna welcome you to the city full of pain. It's another day alone, it's a war to survive. I'm all on my own, hope to make it home alive. It's the street life, street life. It's the street life, street life. My heart turned to stone, man, it's almost like I died. You could run and run forever, but there ain't nowhere to hide. It's the street life, street life. It's the street life, street life. It's another day alone, it's a war to survive. I'm all on my own, hope to make it home alive. It's the street life, street life. It's the street life, street life. My heart turned to stone, man, it's almost like I died. You could run and run forever, but there ain't nowhere to hide. It's the street life, street life. It's the street life, street life.
Misery makes better.